Good afternoon, students. The topic of today's lecture is job analysis. In this topic, we will be understanding various aspects of job analysis, including its definition, including two aspects of job analysis, then various steps of job analysis and techniques. Now, first definition which we'll study is what is a job? A job may be defined as a collection or aggregation of tasks, duties, and responsibilities, which as a whole are regarded as a regular assignment to individual employees. So job is basically a collection of tasks, duties and responsibilities which are assigned to a particular person, and that person has to fulfill that job, complete that job within a particular time frame. Moving further. In other words, when the total work to be done is divided and grouped into packages, we call it a job. So students, for example, if a company has particular objectives and goals, and to achieve those objectives and goals, they hire workforce, the workforce is working for them, and those objectives are being subdivided into that workforce, and when individual person perform his or her task, that becomes his or her job. Each job has a definite title based upon standardized trade specifications within a job. Two or more grades may be identified where the work assignments may be graded according to skill, the difficulty in doing them, or the quality of workmanship. Further, a job may include many positions. For a position is a job performed by related to a particular employee. So students, every job has some kind of title, and that title is according to the hierarchy of that particular organization. And whenever the such title is given, that is being given in accordance with the skill, the difficulty in doing that task, or the quality of workmanship. So basically, job is a task which is being assigned to a particular person out of a big chunk of objectives and goals which are to be achieved on a bigger level, and when each individual performs his or her tasks, that becomes his or her job. Now we will study the definition of job analysis. It is a systematic analysis of each job for the purpose of collecting information as to what the job holder does, under what circumstances it is performed, and what qualifications are required for doing the job. So, job analysis is a process in which the information is collected. Then, what kind of job is there, in what circumstances that job will be performed, what are the different qualifications, skill set, knowledge is required to perform that job. So, collection of all these aspects come under the category of job analysis. According to Edwin B. Flippo, job analysis is the process of studying and collecting information relating to the operations and responsibility of a specific job. So, in other definition, as we can see, it is a process of collecting information, then analyzing that information relating to the operations, various processes which are to be performed during that job, and the responsibility of that particular job. According to Harry Wiley, job analysis deals with the anatomy of the job. This is the complete study of the job, embodying every known and determinable factor, including the duties and responsibilities involved in its performance, the conditions under which performance is carried on, the nature of the task, the qualifications required in the worker, and the conditions of employment such as pay hours, opportunities, and privileges. This is the detailed definition of job analysis, in which it is clearly mentioned that it is anatomy of the job. That means we have to dissect that job. We have to break that job into small pieces, and we will be doing complete study of all those pieces from which we will be coming to know about duties and responsibilities of the job, then under which conditions that job will be performed, then nature of the job, how, what kind of job that will be, then qualifications and various other factors. And this definition clearly explains every aspect of job analysis. Students, now we will study the uses of job analysis. First is human resource planning. Now, human resource planning is an aspect in which right person has to be hired, then at right job, he has to be placed at right time, right? So, this comes under the category of human resource planning. And whenever we study a job very deeply, like in job analysis, we are able to perform human resource planning. Second is recruitment. Yes, in recruitment also job analysis play a major role, because whenever we know about all the information about a job, we know about the operations and the processes to be performed in a job, and we also have the knowledge about what kind of skills, what kind of abilities are required in a person to perform that job. So it becomes easier for us to perform the process of recruitment. And similarly, the process of selection, because recruitment is a positive process in which the applications are invited, and selection is a negative process in which suitable candidates are selected out of many. Next is training and development. When we have all the information about a particular job related to its operations and various skills and qualifications required to perform that job, it becomes easy and convenient for us to first of all evaluate the people and then check the requirement of training and development and accordingly plan the whole process and the syllabi of training and development and ultimately provide that training and development to people. Then organization audit. Audit is something which is being conducted on a timely basis to check the performance of the organization. And whenever we have all the details and information about a job under the category of job analysis, it always is a benefit for us. Then job evaluation. Job evaluation is also a very important aspect. And whenever we have all the information about a particular job, about its operations, about its specific knowledge, skills, abilities, then it becomes easier for us to perform job evaluation. Then job design is also an important aspect of HRM, in which we try to make it convenient for people working for us to perform the jobs. We try to simplify the jobs, we try to rotate the jobs, and many other aspects like job enrichment. So job analysis also plays a major role in performing job design. Then performance appraisal. It is a timely process and it is conducted on a periodic basis, in which employees' performance is evaluated. And when we have all the knowledge about the details of a particular job, its operations and various skills and knowledge required to perform that job at a particular level in an organization, so it is always a beneficial part for performing performance appraisal. Then students, next point is career planning. Career planning is a futuristic approach in which employee tries to develop himself or herself, and organization also plays a major role in it. So when we have all the knowledge about a particular job under job analysis, career planning also becomes easier. Then safety and health. Safety and health is the most important part for any organization. Every good organization tries its best to care for his or her employees. And whenever job analysis is conducted efficiently, the safety and health of the employees is given more and more importance, and the scope of safety and health increases. Now, students, moving further, we will study steps, stages, process, procedure in job analysis. First is collection of background information. Whenever we want to conduct an analysis, we must have sufficient information. And the first and foremost step is to collect that information. Second is selection of representative job to be analyzed. Then we select a job to be analyzed. Then collection of job analysis data. We collect the data, useful data, and we scrutinize that data because some data might be invalid, not up to the mark, and some data is there which is valid and useful. So we will differentiate between that data. Then we will perform job description, in which various roles, responsibilities of a job, what, when, how that job will be performed, all the details are mentioned. After that, we will develop job specification, in which knowledge, skills, abilities of a person is mentioned who has to perform that particular job. So students, this was all about steps, stages and process procedure of job analysis. Now there are various techniques of job analysis data. First is personal observation. Whenever we want to collect the information data to conduct job analysis, first method is personal observation, in which the observer just sits and supervises, observes and notes down all the required information. Second is sending out questionnaires. These questionnaires contain useful questions, valid questions, which help the observer to get those answers which are expected, and he or she can collect the information through questionnaires. Then third is maintenance of log records. Various log records are being maintained and proper information is being collected through those records, which further helps in job analysis data collection. Then conducting personal interviews, when employees are being called upon and they are being talked with, they are being asked various questions, and depending upon their answers, various important information is collected, and that information is beneficial for conducting job analysis. So students, this was all with the lecture for today. This lecture included various definitions of job analysis, various techniques of job analysis, how job analysis is important, and what are the various aspects of job analysis. Basically, if we want to have a successful organization, we must be very much clear about our job analysis part. We have to have important information regarding our jobs, because we must be very clear about roles and responsibilities to be played and what are the various skills, knowledge and abilities required for a person who has to be hired to perform that particular job successfully. So this was all with the lecture, students. If you have any doubt, you are most welcome to ask me. Thank you very much.